Good morning, everybody in second year. So welcome to your assembly this morning, to all second year students and to any of the parents who have tuned into us this morning for this assembly. So I have here this morning, Miss Muldoon Walsh is with us and Miss Summers is with us as well, your year head. And we said we'd connect with you in second year today, just towards the end of the first week back, to see how things are going and to have a chat with you. So, I know it is strange again to be back online and not what we expected after the Christmas, but we have now the next number of weeks together here online, and we want to make sure that things are going smoothly and that everybody understands what's happening and that, you know, we get ourselves focused and organized for the work. Now, I know you guys are in second year at this stage and at the, you know, the second quarter, maybe I suppose to say it that way, of your junior cycle course. The two-year course. So it is very, very important now that you do engage in the work. And this is really the central message that I want to get across to you at the start. Teachers are going to be concerned to cover parts of your course because that work needs to be done. There won't be time to do it after we come back to school because all the rest of the course has to happen. So whatever section of the course that your teachers have decided to cover with you while you're online now, this is the opportunity to do it. The work needs to be done, needs to be covered, and it is really, really important that you engage with it, that you connect into those classes, that you take down the work, that you learn the material, and that you fulfill the expectations of your teacher in relation to whatever has to be done. That's fierce important now, because there isn't going to be a catch-up time later on. So, how have we structured it? Well, you know this. You know it's working and you've seen it now this week. We're following the timetable. We're asking you to click in each day and click into the classes. Check in your Google Classroom how you're having a live class today, or is there a piece of work that the teacher has put up for you? And when does that have to be done by? And what has to be read or learned or written? And to get all of that work done. And you need to keep up to date with that on a day-to-day basis. And this is the second point I want to make to you. We can spend a lot of time now wondering, well, when are we going back and what's going to happen and, you know, all of these questions. And you know what? Now, we don't have the answers. So in the situation where we don't have the answers, all we can do, and that includes the teachers now as well as yourselves as students, all we can do is take it one day at a time. We know we're online today. So today we go to our classes, we do our work, same tomorrow, and we take it each day. And when things change and when things develop, I will be in touch with you and we'll be in touch with you in the school, Miss Muldoon Walsh and Miss Summers, and we'll let you know what's happening and what the next step of the plan is. So for the moment then, I want you to focus day by day on the work that's happening. Put your best energy and your best efforts in and concentrate and dedicate yourself to doing a good job on it now over the next couple of weeks together with your teachers. And I know now that Miss Summers wants to talk to you about a few more details about all of this. So I'm going to hand over to her now. Thank you, Miss Summers.
Thanks a million, Mr. O'Rourke. Happy New Year, everybody. It is strange to be back online again and distance learning and distance teaching, which is, you know, difficult and stressful for everybody. And we all appreciate that. And Miss Muldoon Walsh will actually be speaking to you later about well-being and just, I suppose, different tips on how we can get through the next few weeks. So, lads, I just want to say thanks so much to everybody who's been logging in. There's been a huge turnout, even in my own classes. So we really appreciate it. We really appreciate the effort. And I think the fact that we have structured the day around your timetable is probably helping you, and it's helping ourselves as well. And you're not being overloaded at all hours of the day. So I just want to talk really, lads, about there is a, you know, online etiquette and how we're going to, you know, get through the next number of weeks. Now, the main thing is you log on to your Google Classroom. Now, you have to make sure, lads, that you are signed up to all of the Google Classrooms for each subject. If you're not, can you please make sure you email that teacher? It's your responsibility, really, nobody else's, all right? You're in second year now and you know how this works from last year. So, and I don't want to be in a giving out way, but that is important that at least you can touch base with your teacher there. So go in to your Google Classroom. Teachers will post either a live link to a live lesson, or they will post work for that particular 40 minutes. Now, the majority of teachers, I know I'm doing it myself, are giving people enough time, you know, to get the work done there and then. Because it's tough enough. Like, we don't want you on a screen from 9 o'clock in the morning right through till, you know, 24, and then have another 3 or 4 hours of homework to do. But so just click on the link. Now, when you're clicking on the link to join a class, you've got to make sure you're using your school email. Now, I know I've said it before, you're sick of hearing me, but I know myself, even with, and they're not second years, and I'm going to say that they were, I won't say what year they were, but they did try and access the class through their personal emails. And we have to deny access, lads. We cannot let anybody not on their school email into the class. It's just, we just can't, in relation to GDPR and stuff. It has to be using your school email address. And also, if you're contacting your teachers, can you make sure you use it? And I know it's very easy to send an email on your phone, but really the teachers would feel more comfortable if you're sending through your school email. All right, so that's just that thing. Now, obviously, when you're in the class, it's important that you have everything ready, and a routine is important. And I know Miss Muldoon will mention this again, but like, even the fact that you're up and you're dressed and you're not, you know, lying in bed with your pajamas on, you know, that you're ready to sit at a desk away maybe from the noise. And I know it's not easy for everybody, but, you know, where you have a little bit of peace and quiet, but very important that you have everything you need for that class. So in the same way as, you know, before COVID, you would have to have your textbooks and your copies and everything else, and you were very good for bringing in your refill pads and stuff this year. Have that as well now, because not every teacher is going to screenshot the pages from the textbook and put them up for you. We did that when we were in school because you didn't have your books. And I think we have an advantage because you didn't have your books in school. And I know a lot of secondary school students still have to go and get books from the schools that they're in. So at least you should have them at home. And if you don't, can you make sure that you track down the textbooks? Maybe if it's gone missing since last March, it'd be important that you have that. You'll need it for next year anyway, lads. You know, we're I suppose coming towards the first year of the major cycle for your junior cert. So you've got to have those textbooks. A lot of them are cover the first 3 years, so you'll need them. Obviously, you have your copies, you have pencils, everything you need for that class. If you're not in, or if you're not online, a roll is called, and it may be done more than once, so just be aware of that. If you're not online, you will be marked not online. And basically what will happen that then is, if it happens more than once, teacher will contact you via Google Classroom, will send you a personal message, and then a text message will be sent home by the teacher, and then it will be escalated up to myself or Miss Muldoon Walsh. Listen, I have been, and Miss Muldoon Walsh will agree to this, I've been searching the house to try and find a space. I won't even tell you where I am, but I did have the internet, there was no lagging and the whole thing. So, you know, we all have technological issues. There's four of us here at this particular moment in time. There's a call going on. I'm here. There's a Zoom call going on with my 10-year-old. It's difficult. It is hard on everyone. But, you know, if there are any reasons that you can't be online, can you just please email your teacher? There's no point emailing me to say that you didn't get out of bed till 4 o'clock. And you missed all your classes. You need to speak to the teacher. You need to email the teacher directly and let them know, Lance. Really keep the lines of communication open with your subject teacher and with your subject. And I know everybody's watching this are the ones who are logging in anyway, but that's really important. So like, you know, even if you miss one class, just let them know whatever it is. There could be an internet issue. There could be an access to device issue. It could be just that you weren't feeling very well. It could be that you were at your nana's or your auntie's or whatever. That's fine, as long as we know. There is no point, lads, in just ignoring it and hoping the problem will go away. It's not going to. And I really feel very strongly that if you don't engage with us over the next number of weeks, it'll be very hard to get back into it when you go back to school. We will be back to school this year. I firmly believe it. I'm not sure when. I don't think anyone knows when, but we will be back. And I cannot wait to see your faces, really. Now, when you're in class, we expect the same level of behaviour. And in general, the second years have been really good, you know, when you're in first year and in second year, and classroom behaviour is excellent. So we will expect that level of behaviour as well. So as our default, lads, we have the microphones off. and the camera is off. And that is for your sake as much as our sake, because obviously, you know, if there's a lot of noise and stuff in the background, you don't want the rest of your class knowing what's going on. And, you know, the younger brother is roaring or something. You don't, you know, nobody needs to know that apart from yourselves. So, but if the teacher asks that you turn them on, can you please make sure that you do? Now, I know myself that I will always ask people to call or say yes to present, whatever, if when I'm going to roll. And I'll always ask them to turn on the camera a couple of times, because I love seeing your faces, especially without the masks. So it's great. And please do so. But that's the main thing. Obviously, the chat, lads, must be only used for, you know, teacher questions, basically, to clarify something, to make sure that if you're not sure about something, and that is basically it. Just so that you know, teachers can mute people and unmute, which I've had to do myself. And they can also block somebody from class who might be messing or who might be causing trouble. And if that continues, then we're going to have to look at maybe suspending accounts, but that shouldn't be an issue with you. I think that's kind of it. I just want to say good luck and best of luck with everything. And I really can't wait to see you all again. And that's it, I think, Miss Multon Walsh. Now I'm going to hand over to you, and best of luck, lads. I'm going to put my phone on mute now. Bye bye.
Thank you, Miss Summers. Hello, second years. Welcome back, and well done to you all on the engagement so far since we started back on Monday. Because by all reports from all your teachers, you're doing very well. You're engaging for every class, and you're really, really, really starting off on a great foot. So I'm just going to talk to you a little bit today about your well-being and about looking after yourselves in the next few weeks. And I can say, while there's always a need to look after your mental and emotional health, during these times, it's more important than ever that we put steps in place to stop us from getting stressed or anxious or overwhelmed. So I'm just going to give you a few tips here that may help you as we get through the next few weeks. So the first bit of advice I can give you is, maintain the routine. And Miss Summers has told you, be up on time, be organized and all that kind of stuff. Just to remind you, online learning will be a mixture of learning. So you'll be doing some independent learning and you'll be doing some online learning. Now, you will be kept busy throughout the day. So keep on top of things. That's a real important tip. Don't put things on the long finger. So if your teacher gives you 30 minutes at the end of class, go offline and to do an assignment for that class. Do it then at that time. That's what your 30 minutes are for. Don't let it build up, because when you let things build up, that's when they get unmanageable and that's when our stress starts and we get overwhelmed with things. Second thing I'm going to say to you is to use your breaks wisely. Now, just like in school, you have breaks. You have your small break every day. You have your lunch break every day. And they are important that you use them to take a break. Don't continue on working. Get out of the room where you are working, if you're working in a room. And it's good to stretch your legs if you can at all, especially when you have more time during lunchtime, but definitely you would have time during the break time as well. Go outside, get a bit of fresh air. Fresh air is great for our mentality and it can freshen us up and wake us up a little bit when we need it. So get out there and get a bit of fresh air. Most important thing is, whatever you do, do not spend your breaks on your phones or on your laptops or your screens. You already have been on them all day long. So take a break and try and leave down the screens, maybe leave them in the room with your work and go and take that break. The other thing that's really important is your sleep. Now, sleep is always important and we know this, and it's really important for our well-being and how we feel. Go to bed at a reasonable time. You know, the same time as if you were at school. We all have gotten used to, over the Christmas, staying up late maybe and sleeping on in the mornings and whatever else. Now it's time to get back to normal. When you're well rested, you function much better. Obviously, your brain works much better and for learning it's much better, but also for coping and for your well-being. We cope with things better when we're well rested. We don't get overwhelmed as easy and we're not irritable. So get your sleep, and I'd advise parents out there to ensure that your son and daughter are getting their sleep and going to bed at a reasonable hour. Miss Summers has touched on it there. We do realise, look, at every single family out there will have a different dynamic going on in your household. You know, one family may be an issue that there are younger siblings in the house that are distracting you from your work. Another household, it may be that there are older siblings who are all in college and you're all sharing the one devices and your broadband could be a problem. So we realise there's different issues in different houses. So what I would say to you there is the key thing is the communication part, as Miss Summers said. Obviously, you can tell your teachers. But if there is a parent at home who feels that you are struggling and your son or daughter are falling behind or overwhelmed or whatever, please contact Miss Summers, the year head, or myself here in the school, and we'll work with you and we'll come up with some sort of strategy to help you and get you through. I suppose I want you all to remember, really, and just want to say to you that this is an exceptional time. It's a time that's going to go down in history. And it's essential that all of you out there are kind to yourselves. Don't beat yourselves up if your day doesn't go exactly as you had planned. You will always have bad days. And remember, even before COVID, we had those bad days. Take things one day at a time. Try your best. Engage with the work. Be on time for your classes and be prepared. And then be forgiving of yourself. If things don't work out one day, tomorrow's another day. Every student in the country is in the same boat as you right now. So just think of it like that and use us as a school for the support you need whenever you need it. I'm just going to share my screen with you now and I'm just going to put up a little prayer for you and we can say it together. It might help you at times. It's just a little prayer for, I suppose, nice to say as we begin our remote learning. So you'll see it here. Lord God, as I begin on this journey of remote learning, be with me. Be the patience when I'm frustrated. Be the endurance when I am tired. Be the wisdom when I am uncertain. Be the inspiration when I'm out of ideas. Be the comforter when I feel overwhelmed. Be the energy when I'm weary. Be the guide when I'm confused. And be the forgiver when I get it wrong. Look over me and guide me. Amen. So that's all I have to say. Thank you, everyone, for listening. And I'll hand you back to Mr. O'Rourke.
Thank you very much, Ms. Muldoon and Ms. Summers. So there we have it. That brings us to the end of our assembly with you in second year. We have made a great start, lads, as both your year ahead and your deputy principal have said to you. Great start made by second year students. Tusma la nahibra. So half the work already done. Let's keep up the good work now over the next couple of weeks. And please God, we'll be back in school before we know it. In the meantime, take care and keep safe. Bye for now.